not easy. The contact, impact, I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby, 'cause I can't get enough.
Dice que no le es suficiente, está mal de la mente. Cuando está solita que entre, música para ponerla en ambiente, yeah. Ella quiere que coma aquella bella, le busco todo. Todo lo que se pone bonito se le ve. Empezamos a pie y ahora andamos en el jet. Vamos a calentar, baby, tú. No se quiere olvidar, lo quiere recordar, baby.
'Cause I can't get enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Latino camp.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
You have a bunch of players that have made the draft pool for season three. What advice would you give upcoming players that are looking to get into the league right now and that are waiting for this big day approaching?
Probably the biggest advice that I give anyone is work hard at it and understand it, that you're gonna have to sacrifice. So whatever it is in life, no matter whatever the job is, no matter what you're trying to pursue, you're gonna have to make sacrifices and just grind. And the word grind is like
2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA. The 2K Sports Pregame Show.
Welcome, NBA fans, in tonight's presentation. The New Orleans Pelicans face off against the Bulls in Chicago. Last outing for Chicago, unsuccessful, coming away with a loss to Toronto. That game was high scoring. Tonight, they'll need to be better defensively. And we'll see Drew Holiday. Fellas, you talk about the emergence of the combo guard. Holiday's a good example of how roles in the backcourt have morphed.
You know what? I've seen this kid play since he was in high school. He's a California native.
Really?
Seen him, all of his brothers, all of the same time. He's a rising star. Passes like a one, scores like a two, defends like a three. What else do you need?
Yeah, but when people say Anthony Davis didn't have enough talent around him, they were not talking about Mr. Holiday. His ability and versatility is unreal.
And with that, it's just about time for the tip. We'll see you later.
The Chicago River winding its way through the heart of the Windy City. Our sight tonight. It's the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan courtside with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and our reporter tonight on the sideline, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Well, some say Jrue Holiday is the best defender in the league that no one talks about. He said, "I don't need any accolades. I don't like being famous. But for guys to remember how I play defense on them, that respect, that's the only accolade I want. It's fun for me. Playing myself to total exhaustion." Kevin?
What a great attitude. He is a monster on defense. David, thank you. Already it's February. Hard to believe. Let's see how the West is matching up. Taking a look at New Orleans. They're way down there in the conference standings, looking for a lot of improvement during the second half of the season.
And I think for New Orleans, they've had such a disappointing season. Even when they've gotten a little bit of momentum, they haven't been able to keep it going.
And when you talk about inconsistency, I think a lot of it has to go to the players, because ultimately they're the ones that dictate how they perform.
And the starting lineup for the Pelicans, Ingram the three and Zion the four. Ball and Holiday combine at the guard spots, and it's Favors in at the five spot. And for the Bulls, Satoransky runs the point with LaVine at the two. And it's Young, and it's Cornette in at the five, roaming the paint. And coach Jim Boylan agreeing to a multi-year extension with the Bulls this summer, Greg.
And taking that interim tag off his title as head coach, Boylan, with over 30 years of coaching experience, afforded the opportunity to continue developing this young core.
And so the New Orleans Pelicans get the first points of the ballgame. Young passes to LaVine. And the three off target. And Holiday kicks to Williamson over Young. And there's Williamson on the assist by Holiday. Williamson's got his second bucket of the game to go. And so Satoransky will bring it up for the Chicago Bulls. Four-point game. Pass to Hutchison. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Satoransky with it. Now guarded by Ball. Back to Young. Down to five on the shot clock. And Clark, talk about the leadership of a guy like Thaddeus Young.
And he's one of my favorites because he's just solid. His actions speak louder than his words, and he's a grinder. I mean, he's a guy who just gives you everything he has and does all of the little things day in and day out. Tremendous locker room presence.
It's his first trip to the line. He's off on the first. Players getting a rest, Clark, with the All-Star break coming up. That's important, too. And broadcasters, too, Clark. I know you and I like a little time away to spend with our families.
Nothing like relaxing and getting away from it a bit. I love being fully immersed in it, Kevin. Basketball has given me more than I can ever repay it. But it's just like with my wife. There are times when it's nice to be apart.
No good on the second free throw. A starter in this league for almost a decade, Thaddeus Young's numbers, Greg, blow you away. So what is it that makes him a winning player?
I think it starts with his defense, Kevin. Drawing charges and getting deflections. His quickness puts him in a position to make those effort plays.
Chicago with the ball, following the score by New Orleans. Down low. That's good, and it's LaVine with the assist.
Boy, a terrific find. LaVine plays mostly the two, but he came into the league as a point guard.
And first time out of the game called for New Orleans.
And how much fun is it to watch this kid? I call Zion Williamson a kid, even though he goes about 280. And he has a certain composure that really belies his years.
Here's Ingram. 32 points for him last game against Milwaukee.
And if you look at his free throw numbers, you can see what kind of pressure he put on the defense. He was in attack mode all night long.
And with Williamson, it's not just the obvious stuff that impresses you, Greg. It's the little things as well, the attention to detail.
You know, Kevin, one thing that stands out to me, every time I see this young man, the eye-hand coordination, whether it's on steals, deflections, block shots, he always seems to pick it clean.
5 of 5 to start the game, and it might be the second quarter before they miss. The way they're knocking these shots down, boy, everything's pure.
Shots good from Young.
Well, he's so skilled from this area. Once Young gets it in a good spot, he's looking to score.
Ball with it, now defended by LaVine. Bucket is good.
And this has been a great job of just getting into the middle of that defense and really scoring effectively from the paint.
Now, here's Satoransky. He gives his team some nice contributions, averaging a bit over 10 points a game. Stolen by Ball. One-on-one fast break. And Ball slams it in.
And Ball showing you nice activity on the defensive end there, Kevin, causing problems because of that reach and the quick hands.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Ball. First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play. Satoransky, the pass to Young. Nice move.
Impacting the game now at both ends. Zion moves his feet well and can change directions. Oh, that was worth the price of admission. And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
And, you know, establishing that physical dominance early gives you a big mental edge, too. Don't discount that.
Satoransky, the pass to Cornette. He dishes it to LaVine. Satoransky in the corner. Clock at 6. Feeds it to Young. A second chance effort. And the rejection by Favors. And here comes Holiday leading the fast break. And the dunk by Williamson.
Excellent all-around performance so far. Hence the big lead.
Yeah, you know, they've had the advantage at both ends. They've got all the momentum early on.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket. And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
This team is rolling right now. Still haven't missed a shot.
Bulls trail by 14. And Satoransky kicks to LaVine. And Ball comes to help. Back to Satoransky. And denied. He sends it right off the glass. Holiday attacking over LaVine. The shot by Holiday, no good. Bulls have gotten just 3 of their first 9 shots to go down in this game. Here's Hutchison. He's covered by Favors. Hutchison passes to LaVine. Basket good.
He's becoming a more well-rounded scorer, guys. Buckets like this demonstrate LaVine's ability to finish from anywhere.
Here's Ingram. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
You know, his teammates calling him the slender man. Brandon Ingram, not much more than 200 LBs, but adding strength has been a focus.
Shooting 2.
And he makes the first. And with Brandon Ingram and his size, he could benefit from adding a few pounds.
Well, you know, his teammates call him Tiny Dog. Dog because of his determination. That's a positive thing. The tiny part in reference to his slight frame. Time to bulk it up, young fella. Weight room.
Both free throws. Good for Ingram.
Probably as close to a sure thing as you can have at the free throw line.
And it's Brandon Ingram with the foul. That's his first foul. Bulls trail by 14. Satoransky with it. Still looking for his first bucket in this one.
And they've done a nice job controlling the defensive backboard to start this game.
Not one second chance bucket allowed.
Oh, that was terrific!
Good.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
And, you know, it's an all-out effort they've come in with. Very aggressive offense so far.
On the wing, LaVine. Young outside. There's the triple. That's good, and it's LaVine with the assist. LaVine's got three assists in the game. Here's Ingram, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Ingram's got six.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
And to battle back, they've got to shore up the defense. I mean, there's no other way to come back from a deficit unless you play good defense.
Ball. He makes another one. That's four up and four in to start his game.
How about he has yet to miss 4-4 to start?
Yeah, he's setting himself up to be their go-to guy today.
Sadoransky gets the bucket. Pelicans leading by 12. Here's Ball. Another one falls for New Orleans.
Nothing like having a little size on your side. Lonzo Ball using his size. Even though he's getting body, he's able to stay with the shot.
Outside, LaVine. And Derek Favors pulls it down.
Well, I admire the fact he's trying to power through this rough stretch, but on occasion, you'll have periods like this.
And really, an underrated playmaker. Williamson with good court vision and solid decision-making.
Inside. And the basket by Hutchinson. 5 points in the game.
Yeah, and there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
They grab their own miss. Here's Favors. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
Their interior has been inferior defensively. It has got to tighten up.
You're right on target there, Greg. Of the last 10 points they've allowed, 8 have come from in close.
Here's Cornette. That's good. And it's LaVine with the assist. LaVine's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over.
You see Zach LaVine in the Bulls uniform, and it's hard not to think of the trade that sent him here. He was a big part of the deal that sent Jimmy Butler out of Chicago.
Now at the first-year block leaders in the NBA, here are the top rookie intimidators. You take a look at Hayes, a fierce inside defender, tops in the NBA in blocks.
Well, he has clearly established himself as the premier rim protector in this year's rookie class.
And it's so valuable to have a guy back there who can erase mistakes. Really important. On the ball, off the ball, doesn't matter. You put up a shot in his house, and he'll swat it out the door.
Light the pass to Valentine. Passes it to Harrison. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. Let's it go. Offensive rebound, and it's blocked. But they get it back. Here's Valentine, currently averaging almost 6 points a game. From deep. Here's Young, and it's Young finishing it off.
You know, you look at Thaddeus Young, his motor on display there on the boards. One of the reasons he's carved out such a productive, long NBA career.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Yeah, I like the way they're setting the tone. Really playing with a lot of energy here at the start.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Here's Hart. Can't hit that one. Good defensive work there by Young. Here's Harrison. Here's Gafford. Good on the shot, and that shaved the lead to single digits.
Punch, counterpunch. Impressive offensive production early on.
Hey, guys, this is going to be fun now. I mean, we've got ourselves a shootout on tap here.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Quality looks they're getting, and they're capitalizing on them, guys. They have to be happy with this start offensive.
White, wide open, he fires. And the Bulls, another three.
And you have got to honor White on the perimeter. Once he gets comfortable from there, it's going to be bad news for the defense.
Yep, that one goes in there.
And a lot of teams avoid the mid-range jumper, but they seem to be using it well.
I love that mid-range shot, Greg. It's definitely giving the defender something extra to think about.
Gafford, and the layup is good.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
Here's Holiday. Thaddeus Young grabs the miss. Young's got five rebounds tonight. Pass to Valentine. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
And not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
The shot by Holiday, no good.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack.
And the pass to Valentine. Out of bounds, New Orleans will take possession.
And with the break in the action, let's look at the stats for Holiday. Seventh in steals, and he's in the top 20 in assists per game. His talent for creating easy buckets for his teammates, such an asset.
And talk about being top 10 in steals. I love his jumping the passing lanes and then stealing away your dribble. And again, New Orleans has no luck. And here's White. He'll bring it up for Chicago. They trail by six. Harrison passes to Young. Here's Gafford. That's good, and he's now 3-for-4 from the field.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
From that in-between range, they've been the much better team.
Well, when you knock down jumpers like that, it opens everything else up as well.
And the shot goes down.
An assertive offensive player, White knows he has the green light to rise and fire.
That's tipped. And here comes White, leading the fast break. Offensive rebound, but they recover it. And Young kicks to Harrison. They shoot again, and it's Chicago scoring again.
I tell you what, guys, there's not much more he can do. I mean, he's been on fire. Yet they still trail in this game.
Here's Holiday on target from 13 feet. Holiday's got 8 points.
Impressive, really, from that short 17 area. They are not missing many.
You're exactly right. I mean, they've banged home 8 of their last 10 points on mid-range jumper.
Young banked in off the glass.
You know, he might look a little thin, even wiry out there, but Young is strong. And he has no issues finishing after a bump or a hack.
Here's Holiday, and he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
Monster quarter for him. He's put the team on his back, trying to carry them to the W.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. Ryan Archidiakono now checked in for Valentine. And the Pelicans also making a change. Okafor's checked in.
What's up?
Free throw, no good for Holiday.
It definitely has the respect of the locker room. Holiday is someone that players enjoy playing with.
And New Orleans pushing it up now. Redick's got the ball, and it's good for two.
Outstanding pass in transition there for the easy deuce.
8 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Here's Archidiakono. The offense coming free and easy as we wrap up the first quarter. Pelicans ahead, up by 6. From the United Center in Chicago, back in a moment. And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Pelicans.
Well, they've come out of that locker room with a hot hand. Those jumpers have been falling for them.
And also, how about the fact defensively they're getting that backboard and getting out in transition, especially in this first half.
Bulls trail by six. A whole new cast of characters for the Pelicans. Three promising first-round picks, Greg, and the young players acquired from the Lakers and veterans like Favors and Redick.
All of a sudden, a wealth of options for Alvin Gentry. Time will tell how they did in the AD trade, but seems like they're off to a nice start.
In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. So for New Orleans right now, Holiday at the one and Redick at the two. Hart is out there with Hayes, and it's Okafor in at the pivot spot, manning the middle.
And a solid playmaker, White has a great sense for when he should look to give it up.
The Bulls shooting one of the high points for them in this game at 54%. It's enemies a very efficient 5-for-6 on the game.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from the paint.
Here's Holiday, and that one is off. And it's Chicago the other way. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to the Raptors.
Yeah, on the road, you're already a little out of your element. Then the misses from the line become contagious.
And, you know, one of the things about missing free throws is not only are you not getting points yourself, but it allows the other team to maintain momentum or keep a rally going.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense, Greg, has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. Four straight field goals have been made off an assist.
A lot of smart guys playing in the NBA right now, Clark. Any that you spot that could be a great future head coach in this game?
There are so many of them, Kevin, when you spend time around guys and watch how they carry themselves on the court. Usually you look at point guards because they're quarterbacks and coaches on the floor in many cases. CP3, I don't know if he has a desire to coach, but he certainly talks and feels the game as a coach. And Mike Conley, I think he too has the type of cerebral approach to the game that could lend itself to coaching.
That's an excellent starting list. Balls checked in for New Orleans. Both free throws good for Okafor.
Tell you, when it comes to low post scoring, Okafor is a legitimate beast inside. A player with a lot of upside.
To the inside. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Well, I tell you what, his vertical is awesome. Off the charts, a short center who still makes his presence felt.
Baseline try. Chicago grabs the miss. Young's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. White the pass to Archie Diakono. Over Okafor. And Okafor with the block.
Boy, I love the defensive game of Okafor. He's got a wide reach, and that allows him to get to a lot of shots.
Clock at 4. Here's Archie Diakono. And that won't go, missing the go-ahead bucket. His first shot coming late, and he drops that one in. Hayes has got his first 2 points of the night. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. Pass to Gafford. Over Okafor. It's rebounded by New Orleans. At one point, they led by 16. Following this game, they'll hit the road to challenge the Pacers at Pacers Arena in Indianapolis. That will conclude their brief two-game road trip.
He has the ability to get to the basket, too, like seeing Redick put it on the deck and get it done off the dribble.
Archie Diakono kicks to White. Redick with the double team. The kick out to Young. Shot clock at 6. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession. Chicago ball. Chicago making some changes. Chandler Hutchison, he's checked in for Young. And LaVine subbed in for White. And a change for the Pelicans. Brandon Ingram, he's checked in for J.J. Redick. Puts it up off the inbound. Gafford misses. Pelicans leading by six. And slam dunk by Ingram.
Nice play, and you can see they're gathering momentum.
You know, they need to stay aggressive here. Build the lead up while they've got the chance. Don't waste this opportunity.
Harrison passes to Gafford. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Excellent D there from Okafor. The Pelicans have gone 4 of 7 from the field in this second quarter so far. Again, the Pelicans score.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the team.
And so, it's Archie Diacono with it. He brings it up for Chicago. It's a 10-point game. Knocks it loose. And New Orleans pushing it up now. Here's Hart. And a strong finish with two hands.
Good vision that time by Ball. You need somebody open around him, and he's going to get the ball to him.
And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. And 4 years at Villanova for Josh Hart, won the title back in 2016.
He just makes winning plays, hits perimeter shots, and the 30th pick in 2017, he has been solid.
For the Bulls. Satoransky comes in for Shaquille Harrison. Derek Favors checked in for New Orleans. Outside, LaVine to the right side. And the Bulls with another miss.
No matter what looks they get, they just can't convert to stop this run.
And, you know, they've got to be careful because this is when the team concept breaks down and guys start playing hero ball.
There it is, guys. One of those effort plays that makes a big difference in the game.
And, GA, it is definitely making a difference so far today.
Well, you know, if you're not going to take care of the defensive glass, it's going to be hard to come away with the win.
Ball with the bucket. Ball's got 14 points.
Lonzo Ball, once he catches fire, he can heat up in a hurry. It's tough to throw him off his game.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Top of the key. And it's good off the back of the rim and in. He's got 16.
Give them credit. Offensively, they've been the more efficient team.
Well, you know, it's been all high percentage shot for them so far. I mean, just the kind of execution you want in the first half.
Outside, LaVine puts up a three. Pelicans pull it in. Hart's got 5 rebounds tonight. Here's Ball. But he stays with it. Over LaVine. Ball with the bucket. Ball's got 8 here in the quarter.
Second chance points always hurt. Just not enough effort to block out.
Hey, guys standing around spectating. I mean, you got to get in there and get tough.
And again, Chicago, no good. Pelicans leading by 18. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, one of the things that teams are more aware of in the age of analytics is the importance of sleep. And those teams are making adjustments. Morning shoot-arounds have been moved in some cases to the afternoon or eliminated altogether. There are many fewer teams that are taking red-eye flights across country. And some teams even give players orange tinted glasses to encourage them to sleep. There's a lot of work to be done in this field, but the direction is clear.
Continuing to evolve. All right, David, thank you.
One shot.
Clark, you ever think we'll see a player coach in the NBA again?
I don't think so, Kevin. The role is just so demanding. You know, it requires so much, and there's so much scrutiny now. I don't think you can effectively play and coach in this day and age. No, I don't think you'll see it happen.
Last one we saw was Dave Collins back in the late 70s, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's right. That's a long time ago, man.
Boston Celtics.
Yep.
And that one's good. Ingram.
Yeah, you know, he's slight of build, lanky and long and athletic, but he still finishes through contact, and he's not afraid to go in there and take the hit either.
And a fast break now for the Pelicans, and slam dunk by Ingram.
Well, there you go. One team operating on all cylinders at both ends, steals, fast break buckets, and the other team in scramble mode.
Chicago's got nothing but zeros from long range in the second quarter. 0-4. In the corner, it's LaVine. That three off the mark.
He is just really almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been poor. And they've had assists now in their last three baskets.
And so Sadaransky will bring it up for the Chicago Bulls. And Ball comes to help. Pass to Hutchison. Beyond the arc. Okafor grabs the miss.
He hit one three in the first, but the well has been totally dry for him in the second.
Favors can't get it to go.
Very surprising that he came away empty there, especially given room to operate.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. Lonzo Ball picks one up. The Bulls have not yet made a free throw in the game, 0 of 2 so far.
And taking a look at the numbers on the season, they've converted about 77% of those foul shots.
You know, the numbers from the line, guys, are close to where they were last year, but just a tad worse, so not too bad.
And he knocks down the first one. Well, Clark, at the college level, a coach was recently offered a lifetime contract. Think we'll ever see that in the NBA?
Well, you can't quite say never.
Right.
I said in college basketball, I never thought in my lifetime I'd see a 16 beat a one seed.
Right.
So never say never, but it's not going to happen.
Well, but you've got a lifetime contract doing this, so I guess it does happen in some quadrants.
Well, you got information that I don't have.
He got off to a slow start. It took him a little while to get into the flow of this game, but he's turned it on here in the second.
LaVine can't hit.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here with that cold streak.
And he's got to find other ways to contribute then, because his shot making is not happening right now.
This is some kind of performance we're seeing from him today. He has yet to miss a shot.
Sadaransky, the pass to Valentine. And the rejection by Favors. And that one is stuffed right through.
Well-rounded effort, and they show no signs of letting up.
Almost no holes in their performance tonight. They've been tremendous.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Well, I like seeing LaVine guys waste no time firing away. I think his decision-making and shot selection and passing getting better.
As hot as he's been this quarter, the game plan is simple, folks. Get him the ball and get out of the way.
Cornett passes to Sadaransky. Now Valentine. He's covered by Ball.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
And it's been a well-rounded performance. I mean, strong rebound, and has certainly been at the center of it, but it's been good on a number of levels.
Now LaVine. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against the Raptors in Toronto.
And he also looked to attack at the defensive end of the floor. Three steals in that game.
Well, you certainly can't fault him as the reason they're behind. He's been on target and on top of his game.
Bulls getting their fifth attempt at the line in the game. J.J. Redick's checked in for the Pelicans. Holiday comes in for Lonzo Ball. And the free throw, no good.
That's a great job getting to the line here. You know, he didn't have a single attempt in that first quarter because I thought he was tentative. Much more aggressive here in the second.
LaVine wide open. Gets an open look and hits. LaVine's got 4 points this quarter.
Well, you can see the athleticism there. I mean, LaVine able to stop, gather, and pop in one fluid motion. I know it looked easy, folks, but that's athleticism and giftedness right there.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over. Well, you just watch LaVine play, and you can see the athleticism he possesses. Greg just explodes anytime he wants to.
And guys, with LaVine, the speed and first step have always been there for him. But you can see the strength he's added to his game since his rookie year whenever he goes at the rim.
Comes in for Chandler Hutchison, and it's wide in for Sadoransky, and a change for the Pelicans. Williamson's checked in. Out to the right wing. And stolen by Williamson. Pulls up on the wing, and good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Redick's got 4 points now in the quarter. White against Holiday. On the wing, LaVine. Over Redick. LaVine can't hit.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
And guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
And guys, I like the fact that he chose the one-hand tomahawk slam because you get a little higher when you go off one hand and one foot.
And a long windup and strong follow-through on the one-hand jam.
Yeah, he's not going to mess that one up.
I certainly hope not.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you could hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
For New Orleans, they have shot a good percentage from the free throw line so far. They've made 5 out of 6.
And 74% has been the mark for them on the season thus far.
And guys, that allows their opponents to play very aggressive defense if they choose to, knowing it's not a bad thing to send them to the foul line.
That free throw good from Drew Holiday.
And a great job from the line this quarter. They've gotten their percentage way up there.
And so he hits both.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
Yeah, you have to make teams pay for fouling you. That's why they call them free. And they've done exactly that, made them pay.
LaVine looking around. 6 on the shot clock. Kept alive. Young tries yet again. No good on the layup.
Boy, patrolling the paint well, protecting the rim. That's exactly the kind of defensive effort you need against him.
And it's Melly missing. And so LaVine will bring it up now for the Chicago Bulls. And it's White missing.
And if you ask me what percentage of the time he's making that shot, my answer would be in the single digits.
Well, you can't be forcing a shot like that. You got to keep the ball moving. Get something better.
I tell you, he's playing the game with pure excitement right now.
He capped off that dunk with some serious hang time on the rim.
Yeah, just couldn't contain himself. Couldn't control himself there.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Valentine wide open. He fires, and the three ball is good. Valentine's got 5 points so far. Holiday against White. Holiday gets the bucket.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
You know, he should be getting extra attention from the defense, not less.
And so it's New Orleans, up by 33 points as the buzzer sounds. A huge lead for him. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Alvin Gentry. Coach, you're leading at the half. What will you continue to emphasize to your team?
Well, I mean, defensively, we still have to be good. We got to rebound the basketball. And then we've got to continue to push the basketball and score offensively.
We'll see if you can keep that going in the second half, Coach. Thanks. Back to you.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Good to see you back here on our halftime show. Well, actually, we can't see you, but you can see us, but you get it. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. You're watching the NBA on 2K Sports. There was no stopping Lonzo Ball in the first half.
He had 23 points, 2 assists, and 2 rebounds. Kenny, your thoughts, how the Pelicans are playing.
What a true demonstration of dominance. They made a commitment to owning the glass, and they made good on it. Blocking out, competing hard in traffic, that's the way you should play on both ends of the court.
And Shaq, what'd you think about Chicago?
Well, they got a ton of issues to work out. Allow way too high a percentage to be shot against them. Not really showing any energy on defense. No discipline. Look at their faces, Ernie. Do they even want to be here?
That's all for now. Say goodbye to the folks. Thanks goodbye, for folks. Joining us. Third quarter, just about ready to begin.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. We're seeing a tremendous game from Lonzo Ball.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
You know what? It helped that they had a few guys with very hot hands on the perimeter, too.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. And Chicago shooting at a decent 44% clip here. Satoransky runs the point with LaVine at the two. And it's Young, and it's Cornette in at center. So that's the five in the game for Chicago. Outside, LaVine fires for three. Ball with the rebound.
And there have been some terrible shot choices here, Kev. That's not a good look at all.
Holiday gets the bucket.
And Ball knows how to distribute the ball. Pun intended, for sure. An impressive point guard who continues to improve and impress as a passer.
He was all alone on that one. And it's 9 points for Zach LaVine.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooting.
And that's out of bounds. New Orleans will retain possession. And here is Williamson. It's good.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking
at the rim.
You're exactly right. It's been all good at one end, and let's be diplomatic and just say not so good at the other end.
From 15 feet away, Thaddeus Young grabs the miss. Young's got 11 rebounds in the game. Right side, LaVine. From 15 feet away, again, LaVine missing.
Just 1-for-4 from the field, not the way they wanted to start the second half.
Here's Favors, and they cash in right away with a quick shot. Favors got 6 points.
And I want to see more of that from him. I mean, he's been passing up on his shot more than usual, even though he's hitting the ones that he takes.
LaVine kicks to Sadaransky. Lobs it up for LaVine. Deft touch on the alley-oop.
Oh, and just a soft touch on both ends of that pretty alley-oop.
I got to say, when he threw the pass, I didn't know where it was going.
Neither did the defense.
Took him no time at all on that one. Ingram's got 22.
The nice shooting ability of Ingram makes that mid-range J a quality shot.
Here's Hutchison. And so the ball's out of bounds. Favors touched it last. Here's Sadaransky. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago.
Their game plan needs to change if they're going to get out of this hole because he is just not there offensively.
Holiday gets the bucket.
You know, you look at Ingram, and it's not all about scoring with him. He shows he shares the ball as well.
Cornette passes to Sadaransky. LaVine for three. The shot's good on the assist by Sadaransky. Sadaransky's got assist number 7 for him tonight. Here's Ball. Thaddeus Young grabs the miss. Young's got 12 rebounds here tonight. Big time effort. Here's Hutchison. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It goes on Brandon Ingram.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
Clark, I want to take you back a bit here to 1982. What was going through your mind over your first few NBA games?
Take a break.
Well, Kevin, first of all, I was really excited and thankful to have a chance to realize a dream, but I was also a little bit nervous going up against some of the guys that I had watched and idolized from afar. But once you're between those lines, it's not about idolizing guys. It's about trying to posterize them.
Any player in particular, one player that you looked out on the floor and you were out there as well saying, oh, my goodness, look who I'm playing against tonight?
Well, when we first saw the Celtics and the Sixers, Larry Bird and those great teams in the 80s, Cedric Maxwell and Kevin McHale, and then the Sixers, my rookie year, won it all. And they had Moses Malone, Dr. J, Bobby Jones, some of the greats in the game. So those two teams and Dr. J and Larry Bird in particular.
And he makes that one.
Excellent shooting from the crafty guard. Ball is extremely reliable and consistent. Has a very solid pull-up jumper.
Sadaransky, the pass to Young. A moment to check out who the New Orleans Pelicans have coming up. On Saturday, they'll be taking on Victor Oladipo and the Indiana Pacers. Then on Tuesday, they'll go up against C.J. McCollum and the Portland Trail Blazers.
And looking at the schedule, it isn't ideal in terms of the upcoming games with the amount of quality teams they're going to be playing, but it's also a good chance for you to get some confidence and really see just how good you are. And team strategies closely guarded. One aspect of the game the fans aren't always privy to.
Yeah, typically there's some type of adjustment made out of a timeout. It might be major, or it could be just a slight tweak.
Check in for the Bulls. This is a look at the NBA's assist leaders for the last 10 games. Gosh, can these guys throw the ball around the court? Here are the real stats, real scores from the real NBA. Lonzo Ball third.
And those games have seen him dropping more dimes than you might have thought possible.
No good on the free throw.
And you know, as good as Young can be in the open court, doesn't quite carry over to his free throw shooting.
And he sinks the second. So Favors will bring it up for the New Orleans Pelicans. Down low, here's Williamson. And he uses the glass on the layup. Williamson's got 18 points.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
I'd agree with you, and I don't think they expected this one to be a game where they would get battered inside like they have.
Here's Young. Blanketed by the D, he fights to the rim for the layup. He's got 16.
Well, you can't rattle Young. I mean, when he's focused on scoring, there's little the defense can do to stop him.
They get it again. And the dunk by Williamson.
When he's on the floor, offensive rebounding is always going to be a strength for them.
Greg, he keeps so many possessions alive, doesn't he?
And, you know, those second-chance opportunities can be game-changers. He represents so much value to this team because of what he does.
Ball against Satoransky. Here's Cornett. The three-pointer off the mark. The Pelicans have gone 8 of 12 from the field since the beginning of the third. Here's Williamson. Sinks it from just inside the baseline. Williamson's got 22 points.
And what you love about Williamson, he's not just magnetic and entertaining. He's extremely productive.
Pass to Hutchison from downtown. He can't get that one to fall. And it's the Pelicans taking it the other way. Here's Williamson. It's good, the assist that time from Holiday. Holiday's got 3 assists in the game. Chicago's gone 2 of 5 with a 3-point shot since coming out of the break.
And maybe the most popular player to enter the league since social media became truly pervasive. Zion Williamson handles it with class. He really appreciates his teammates and his coaches and really respects the game.
The ball distribution was there. I mean, outstanding work all the way around.
Here's Ball. And it's Chicago with the rebound.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
And talking to stars in this league, even they want to see what Williamson's going to do next.
Sure. We talk about the leaping ability at his size, the handles, the shot making. But what really stands out when you watch him live, the instincts. Being at the right place at the right time and always seeming to make the right play.
The first free throw is good. The Bulls making a switch here. Archie Diakono's checked in. A big group substitution here for New Orleans. Okafor's checked in for Favors. Hayes comes in for Williamson. J.J. Redick's checked in for Ingram. And it's Josh Hart in for Lonzo Ball. He hits both from the stripe. Well for New Orleans, shooting 71% all in all in this one. They've been brilliant offensively. And that one is good.
J.J. Redick.
Bulls have gone 5 of 12 from the field since the third quarter got underway. And Satoransky kicks to Young. Rebounded by Hart. Hart's got rebound number 7 for him tonight.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Guys, that's putting it mildly. I mean, they've been absolutely dominant.
Holiday brings the double team. Here's Cornett. Bangs home the trifecta.
Cornette's got 11.
Wow, something's brewing, guys. The three-pointers just continue to flow.
Yeah, they've had a great second half from long range, Greg. I mean, things are definitely starting to look up for them.
Here's Archie Diakono. Here's Sadoransky. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans. Hart's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Over Harrison. Hart, no good. Now Chicago has gotten the three-pointer to fall to the tune of 50% here in the third quarter. They've made 3 of 6. And again, no good by Chicago. Doesn't go that time. So the Bulls will take it the other way. The pass to Harrison. And the shot is good. Harrison's got 4 points in the quarter.
And that lead pass allowed him to get straight to the rim, unabated, in stride.
Holiday. Rebound by the Bulls. Here's Archie Diakono. No good on the three. New Orleans dictating the flow. Goes up on the wing. Sadoransky grabs the miss. And Chicago shooting 39% from the floor since the half. Not really what they had in mind. Nice shot from the wing. Archie Diakono's got his second basket of the night.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Here's Holiday. Chicago grabs the miss. Young's got 14 rebounds tonight. Going after. And there's the foul. It'll go on Josh Hart. That's his first foul. Jackson, he's checked in for the Pelicans. White against Redick. From past the arc. And it's White missing. And it's Jackson with the ball, bringing it up for the Pelicans. Hart, that's good. Here's Archie Diakono. Pass to Harrison. Here's Archie Diakono. Guarded by Jackson. Just 5 on the clock. Gafford passes to Harrison. The shot from the low post is good. Harrison's got 8 points.
And that's a nice, strong move in the face of some weak D.
Lets it go from the wing. Hart, that's good.
Wow, 10 straight points from mid-range.
You know what I've always said, partner? Good shooting covers over a multitude of ills. And we're seeing it right now.
Here's White. And Okafor with the block. He's got a clear path. Here's Hayes. Rebounded by Gafford. The Bulls shooting 43% from the field. White against Redick. Inside, Gafford. The shot, no good. Excellent D there from Okafor. Here's Hart. The shot goes down. Very quick possession right there. He's got 18.
You know, so far he's been dominant this period, making the most of his opportunities.
Here's Harrison. And again, no good by Chicago. Here's Redick. The rebound by Young. Young's got 15 rebounds here tonight. Harrison in the corner. He tries for 3. The shot missing. And it's the Pelicans taking it the other way. Passes it to Hart. Okafor trying to get open.
How about Josh Hart making beautiful music all day long? They have no answer for him.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Here's White and Okafor with the block. Hart, that's good. Hart's got 10 points now just in this quarter. And a look at how the hustle game has been going for New Orleans.
Their defense has been outstanding, closing out on shots and blocking a few as well.
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either, and it's resulted in a lot of fast break points.
The shot by Harrison, no good. The Pelicans shooting a stellar 60% since the halftime break.
and it's New Orleans scoring again.
Well, part of their game plan was to block out the noise and just stay focused.
And what's been impressive is that it's not been any one player. It's been a collective effort, contributions from everybody.
Young's shot is off.
And if you ask me what percentage of the time he's making that shot, my answer would be in the single digits.
Well, you can't be forcing a shot like that. You got to keep the ball moving, get something better.
Yeah, taking it right into the teeth of the defense, and it's a defense that's starting to look frustrated.
Well, they should be. I mean, it has not been a good performance for them at that end of the floor.
They need this one, and that one's good. Archie Diacono. Archie Diacono's got 6 points. Shoots from the corner, and he nails the jumper.
Yeah, a big part of this run here has been their ability to score from mid-range.
Kicks to White. Here's Gafford. He's got 8. Young outside. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession.
Still Bulls ball.
Chicago with the ball. Clock at 6. Thaddeus Young on the wing. For 3, LaVine. It's rebounded by Hayes. Hayes has got 8 rebounds in this game. Here's Melly. And too long on the shot. Got it off in time. Doesn't go for him. The 3 quarters of play all in the books. And this one all but over already. New Orleans on top, running away with this one. And when we return, we'll get the 4th quarter rolling right here on 2K Sports. And let's take now this moment to bring up our State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feed.
For me, next to the big-time alley-oops and monster throwdowns, passes like that are probably the next best thing when it comes to sweet-looking NBA highlights.
And we reach the 4th quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. On the court for the Pelicans, getting the 4th quarter going, we've got Williamson. Etwan Moore is out there with Jackson. And it's Alexander Walker in at the 2.
Boy, you can't give him any room to maneuver on the board, because once he does, he's going to make you pay.
Right side, White. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. Pulls up from the corner. A nice shot by Melly.
And this is why coaches talk about playing with pace. The scoreboard tells it all.
That really has been the difference. I mean, they've been the better team in transition.
And a hard finish there, guys.
Yeah, and only one hand needed for that one.
Sometimes that's all you need.
From the wing, and it's New Orleans scoring again.
Yeah, Williamson stopped on a dime there. He's got the footwork and body control like a guard, but he's 280 pounds.
White dishes to Valentine. The last couple years, Clark, we've seen a couple of Hall of Fame level players go on these farewell tours on their final year in the NBA. What a great way for fans of opposing teams to honor these terrific stars.
You know, I was a little bit mixed on how I felt about the farewell tours, but these two were handled so beautifully, and there have been others that have been handled great. It gives the fans an opportunity to express their feelings for some of the greats in the game, and that's heartwarming for all of us, I think.
Yeah, you and I were just talking about the way Kobe and Wade were terrific in their tours. The Bulls have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the 4th quarter. Back to Felicio. And some nice ball movement here by Chicago. The 19-foot shot, good as the jump shot falls. And that's now 7 points for Denzel Valentine. Here's Jackson. Another one falls for New Orleans.
And now you can see the D having problems stopping the mid-range jumper, just not really closing out as much as they need to.
To the paint, Makoka. And it's Melly with the rebound. Melly's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Jackson gets the bucket.
Ripping and running. They have a big advantage now in those transition opportunities.
No expiration date on their legs. They just seem to be fresher. And they're putting those fresh legs to good use.
The Pelicans have gone 5 of 6 from the field to start the fourth quarter on a roll. And that one drops for them.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm. And you can see how they're finishing their plays.
Boy, this is borderline ridiculous. I mean, every single attempt finding the bottom of the bucket.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
Clark, we've had sponsors on the uniforms for a couple of seasons now. Do you think everyone's grown used to seeing them?
Yeah, I think it's a normal part of the landscape, and it will take a little more time. I've noticed them myself as I've watched games. We're certainly a far cry from looking like NASCAR drivers, which I think is a good thing. You want them to be done visibly, but not overdone.
Worked that one inside nicely.
And it's New Orleans scoring again.
Impeccable mechanics this quarter. He's been perfect from the field.
To the middle, Makoka takes the assist and lays it in. Pick out the pass nicely.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Well, I agree with you. 4 of their last 5 baskets have been exactly of that variety.
And Chicago shooting in the fourth quarter has been efficient at 56%. Jacks up a 3. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans. Melly's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Moore. Chicago grabs the miss.
You can't look at the result of that shot. They'll take that whenever they get it.
Well, you know, I hear you. That's a good look. But when you're that wide open, I think you got to knock it down.
Here's Alexander Walker. He clangs that one off the back iron, and down it falls.
I mean, even he was surprised to be that open.
Last season, the NBA announcing the launch of a league in Africa, along with FIBA. Clark, what do you think of that move?
I think it's another example, Kevin, of the globalization of the game and the NBA's intentional, purposeful way of expanding and continuing to grow the game for the sake of the business of basketball, which is a game that obviously you and I love.
And Clark, we see so many foreign players come into the NBA and play well. Not just play, but play well.
Yeah, and not just Africa, although right. A number of players from Africa, but a number of different countries have signed on. It could make for a more exciting league.
Jackson misses. Chicago has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. And yes, it's good.
And 10 of their last 12 coming off assists.
Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over.
The Pelicans call timeout.
Break away and make a way to make it.
Yeah. Cornette is checked in for the Bulls. Satoransky comes in for Valentine.
Tomas Satoransky.
And it's Jackson with the ball, bringing it up for the Pelicans. Count that one as his seventh make in eight attempts, a scorching 88%.
You know, this has been a totally different half for him. He definitely looks more comfortable now, guys.
Makoka, guarded by Jackson, missed inside. The Pelicans shooting an unreal 70% from the field, making a mockery of this defense. Plenty of daylight on that shot. Alexander Walker's got six here in this quarter.
Well, check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates that are clearly on the same page.
Clark, here's kind of an interesting perspective question for you. How much of making it to the NBA is talent? How much of it is the work you put into it?
Kevin, if I were to give this a ratio, I would probably say 65% talent, 35% work ethic.
Wow.
Because you have to have a level of unique giftedness to be an NBA player. Many can work really hard and not be NBA caliber. So I think there's, I tilt that 65-35 talent to work at.
Makoka against the rim with a two-handed slam.
Wow. Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finished hard with two hands on that stuff.
Yeah, highly efficient. Nothing extra special there. Just effective.
And not just a long-range gunner, but Etuan Moore also blessed Greg.
Two shots.
One of the NBA's best floaters.
I mean, he takes a lot of those mid-range shots, those floaters in the lane that makes them more often than not. For a player standing 6'4", the ability to finish inside, providing that counterbalance to his three-point shooting.
That's good for Moore. Clark, when you think of athleticism specifically, talk about the changes athletically we've seen in the league, say, since the 80s.
It's dramatically different. I mean, there have been tremendous athletes through every decade of the league's existence, but it's gotten better with improved training and more knowledge about the anatomy of the body and how to enhance its performance. But now it seems like great athletes are, you know, a dime a dozen versus eight to a dozen back in the 80s.
Tipped away. And New Orleans pushing it up now. Here's Alexander Walker. Buries it from about 10 feet away.
And this is how you want to come out of the half. Prolific and efficient.
Boy, I like the disposition and attitude since halftime. They're patiently looking for good shots. Yeah, you know, we've seen a much different version of him in this half, guys. He's been sharper, more focused, and more assertive.
Jackson gets the bucket.
Yes, sir.
This is a fantastic performance in this half. He didn't play as well in the first, but you just know with this guy, he's always ready to turn it around.
Makoka, and it's off from three-point range. Down low, here's Moore. Lays it up off the glass.
It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well with a pass.
Fires the three. Pelicans with the rebound. Ellie's got 9 rebounds now tonight. Wing shot on the way, and he knocks down the jumper. Moore's got 8 here in the quarter.
And Okafor is also incredible at finding the open guy. I mean, a really good passer. You can't forget about that part of his game.
Pass to Cornette. Mark, should the NBA consider widening the court to even out the value of those corner threes?
You know, that wouldn't be a bad idea, Kevin. But I also like the fact that there's a deep three at the top and on the wing. And then you've got a little shorter three if you can get to that corner. Widening the lane to make that three more in line or symmetrical with the deep three at the top. I kind of like having a short corner three.
I agree with you. Shot clock at six. Chicago needs to get off a shot here. 2 points. That one goes. The Pelicans shooting 71% all in all in this one. They've been brilliant offensively. Chicago's gone into a funk from downtown in the fourth. Only one of their 5 three-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket. And that one's good, Archie Diacono.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Boy, it's been a three-point barrage. They came out gunning and have not stopped.
To the paint. He's now made half of those 10 shots in the game. That's his fifth basket.
And really a good job spotting his teammate near the bucket and then just pinpoint passing for the finish. The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take.
And Okafor with the block. Now here's Moore. Shot is good off the back rim and in. Moore's got 10 points here in the second half. So it's Chicago now. Clark, the relationship between referees and players reaching a fever pitch. What can be done to smooth those waters and mend those fences?
Well, I think first and foremost, players have to give. Both sides have to give in this equation, but I think it's incumbent upon the players to accept and respect the position of the officials, and the officials have to also be willing to engage in interacting well with the players. It's a two-way street, but I think most of that is on the players because they have to control how they respond to officials more than officials have to respond to the player.
Chalk up two there. 6 points for Jahlil Okafor.
Cannot forget to box out Okafor on the glass. I mean, he is relentless in his attack.
Here's Felicio, and there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
Bulls from the top of the key, but they'll get another chance. Makoka. Here's Cornette. It's good. Now he's shooting 6 for 7.
The tenacity on that interior, just battling, bringing that effort and will for second chance points.
Shots good by Alexander Walker.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for the Pelicans.
As one-sided as it gets today, you know, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And I think a great job in positioning themselves for the W here. It's win number 21 on the season.
And they've taken control of the season series. This brings them to 2-0 with one game left against this squad.
And believe you me, they'll be gunning for the sweep in that third meeting.
Inside, Makoka, and he stuffs it. What a pass to set him up.
And I love the fact that he didn't have to slow down or adjust there. The pass was just timed perfectly.
Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over. They're up. There's 45 seconds left here in the fourth quarter.
Thank you.
while, we get a chance to check out our Jordan Player of the Game.
And, Kevin, it's a no-brainer. He's controlled every aspect of this game, and it's just so fun to see a player perform at a level that's just higher than anyone else out on the floor.
Two straight losses coming into this game had them looking for any kind of spark, and he was the one to give it to them with a superb performance off the bench. There's 45 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one, and it's Okafor missing. Guarded by Jackson. Archie Diakono, the pass to Cornette.
You can appreciate the fight now, but it isn't how they came into the game.
Yeah, you know, I agree with you. They waited too long to finally ramp themselves up.
Wasted no time on that one.
They just blocked out the noise, kept on grinding, and this is their reward.
Boy, a fantastic performance. And I tell you something, I mean, you get roadkill, that's always a challenge in the NBA, no matter what. And they got it done.
And it's Melly with the rebound. Here's Alexander Walker. And good, as it just snugs right down through the net.
And credit the whole team. It was a focused, concerted effort to put this one away.
Yeah, what a time to put the hammer down. Any hope of a comeback? Diminished.
So we see New Orleans taking the W here. To come into an opponent's building and dominate the way they did tonight says, I think, Greg, an awful lot about this team.
I guess they don't need home cooking to feel at home. I mean, Kevin, just a masterful performance all the way around.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Jalil, we all know you can score. The defensive end has been the challenge. How did you take that step forward tonight?
My teammates challenged me. The coaches challenged me to get better every night. Just so I can score, but they want to see improvements on the defensive end.
And you took that step forward tonight, Jalil. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. So long.